This video will give an overview of the dynamic lock functionality found on MS60 multi-stations. Dynamic lock enables MS60 to rapidly locate and lock onto a reflective target, even if the instrument and or target is moving. Being able to lock to a target while still moving can save an enormous amount of time and money. It can be particularly useful when working in busy environments where there are many interruptions in the line of sight to the target, and the target needs to be repeatedly and quickly located. Dynamic lock is only available on MS60 multi-stations using Leica Captivate version 2 or higher. Dynamic lock works by the multi-station sending out an invisible vertical laser fan with a width of plus or minus 20 degrees to scan for reflective targets. If a target crosses this laser fan, then the multi-station will detect the target within the fan, quickly perform a search, and then lock to the target, even if it is moving. There are two different search methods which use dynamic lock. One is when using weight and lock, and the other is during a cube search. Note that dynamic lock is not used during a power search. Let's have a look at these more closely. Weight and lock can be used in two different ways. The first is initiating a search by pressing the weight and lock button in the aim and search bubble. To get locked to the target and begin measuring, simply walk across the line of sight of the instrument. The instrument will lock to the target while you're still walking, meaning you're ready to work straight away. The second is when the instrument has lost lock and weight and lock has been selected for the after prediction behavior in the target search panel. The instrument is locked to the target as the point is being staked out. The target now goes behind an object, and lock is lost. Once the prediction phase has ended, the instrument will stop turning and automatically go into wait and lock mode. To regain lock, it is simply needed to move the target across the line of sight of the instrument, which will then lock to the target, and the next point is ready to stake out. This makes it extremely efficient with no need to stand still and wait for the instrument to find the target. A cube search is made when the instrument has lost lock and start cube search has been selected for the after prediction behavior in the target search panel. Let's have a look at two use cases. Imagine during measuring points, the target disappears from view behind a wall and the instrument loses lock. After the target prediction, a cube search will automatically begin. The multi-station will turn back 45 degrees from where the target was lost. As it turns back, the vertical fan will cross the target and then lock to it. Time is saved as there is no need to stand still and wait for the instrument to find the target again. Imagine now a multi-station is being used for machine control and a target is being followed on a dozer. The dozer moves behind another machine and the instrument loses lock to the target. The dozer stops and drives back in the opposite direction. A cube search will start and the instrument will find and lock onto the target even with the dozer still moving. Again, this is a massive time saving because the dozer driver does not have to stop the machine and wait for the instrument to lock to the target. In summary, the dynamic lock function on MS60 multi-stations is a real time and money saver, allowing the instrument to lock onto a target even when it is moving. An enormous amount of time can be saved in no longer having to stop and wait for the instrument to find the target. Thanks for watching.